Hey guys, it is Megan and Margaret back with another episode of Let's Play Sims 3 Seasons, Part 30. Yeah, oh my god, Part 30. Wow. It's amazing. Oh, that's not amazing, but hey, whatever. And Maria just learned how to make eggs McAvillian. Yeah, that stuff. But basically this episode, level 4. Basically this episode is going to be a little weird in the sense that I'm gonna cut a lot of things out and I'm just gonna include like kind of the interesting parts. So for right now, what I kind of wanted to tell you is, Maria, first of all, she learned 28 recipes, which got her this challenge. It's the Menu Maven skill challenge. So she did that, and she learned how to make mushroom omelette, of course, and whatever, oh yeah, eggs thing. Ah, and a jackpot. So that's really great. So how much do we have now? Oh, okay. All right, 564. Okay, oh, whatever. So yes, we also have all that stuff. And both Maria and Jared won the spring dance king and queen. So spring fever, baby. Spring fever, that is. Maria has been named spring dance queen. Her reward will be delivered by mail. And same thing with Jared, except he won the king. So that's awesome. I really like that. That was kind of cool. And I guess that wasn't a jackpot. That was just a bit of money. Yeah, that was a bit of cash. If anything happens with Ruben this episode, because he is 100 days old, pretty old, I will come back and show it off. But for right now, I'm gonna... Oh, he kicked the machine for some money. But, yeah. Oh, the people outside. So, yeah, if anything kind of interesting happens, I will come back to it. Like, if anything at all. So, yeah, for the most part, everybody's kind of, like, doing nothing except her. I think she's nauseous again, so that's kind of cool. So yeah, I'm just gonna have them do their stuff and come back if something happens. All right, guys? All right. Hey guys, I'm back again. Well, for the first time, but yeah. So some things that happened. First, Ruben just, you know, switched the machines, but I invited Carmen to come here and help us win some money, I guess. But yeah, so first what happened was Ruben gained or had a jackpot of 5,000 simoleons, and then Jared finished his book. Oh, what a nice machine. Yeah, before I do anything, I'm gonna pause the game for right now. But yeah, he finished that, The Secret Life of an Everyday Dancer. He finished that, and he's gonna get 6 royal payments of 46 simoleons, which is, you know, whatever, but okay, whatever, we'll live. And then Ruben improved his gambling skills to level 6, and then Carmen got a jackpot her first time trying, which is really, really awesome. And then her gambling skill improved to level 1, and then we got like notes in the mail and stuff, and she got the silver and iron ingots in the mail too. And then Carmen got another jackpot. Wow. And then he started another novel, which is a nonfiction novel, and it is How to Dance. And yeah, oh my god, that chew toy. My windows are open because it's a wonderful day today, so I'm sorry if you can hear that. It's probably really loud for you guys, maybe, I'm not sure. But and then yeah, so that machine totally failed on him, so I guess he stopped. It was a cold slot machine. Oh no, the cooler strikes again, and he's losing. So I forget that feeling that everybody's winning but you, and he's also feeling unlucky, which, you know, whatever. So we got 6,196 simoleons from that, and I'm pretty sure we spent all those simoleons on books for Maria. All of them are like recipes and stuff. And the things that we got at home, she's actually going to work right now. She can hang out with her coworkers, but let's look at the house. We probably won't be able to see. Yeah, okay. We have to wait till she gets to work, but that's basically what happened. And yeah, she improved her skills to level 2, but I want to show you when she gets to work, because she's traveling right now, or she's moving around. Okay, she's done moving around. So let me show you these two things that we got from being the queen of the queen of a dance and the king of the dance. So yeah, so this is the king one, as you can see by the crown. It's really nice, and it's just we can view it, which she's not home right now, but that's that. And then this is the queen one, so I think it's kind of nice. I think those are cute. Yeah, those are nice. That's cool. All right, so that's kind of it. I'll come back to you whenever, you know, whenever. So yeah, I hope you guys, whoa, her face when it didn't load in, that was scary. That was a little scary. Okay, so I'll come back whenever. Oh, I'm back so soon. No, I'm kidding. Yeah, this episode might be, like, really, really out of it. Like, it's so random and just all over the place. I'm sorry. I really am. But the reason I'm doing this is because I do want them to get us some money without wasting a lot of parts of them. Whoa. Of them just doing this, kicking machines and hoping they get something good. But see, she just got bad. Maybe I'll have her switch to another machine because she ain't doing so well right now. But let's see. But yeah, the reason I'm doing this is so they can get a lot of money and for their new house. I built it. I finished it. I think I built it in like 2 days or something like that, which is, you know, okay. It's good. And yeah, I'm done. But it's like they have total funds are like, he's gonna stop that because he's losing and he needs to pay. So, oh, what? Oh, she's pregnant. Look at that. She's gonna go play on those afterwards. But yay, she's pregnant. Yeah. So right now they have, half the amount in the family funds total that they need for the house. Like, furnished, like, I looked in the furnished their house, like, I'll show you. Oh god, she's wearing this outfit, and she wants a boy. Let's see what Derek wants. He doesn't know yet. Look at that! That's just, ugh. Don't mind that. But, yeah. So, I'll come back whenever something happens. See you then. Hey guys, okay, so nothing really, it's not all that interesting, but I just decided to read these stuff again. Well, before I read them, I just wanted to show you this new mood lit. I don't think we ever shut it off, but it's a losing streak. The good news is you're on a streak. The bad news is it's a losing streak. I can't talk. Yeah, I'm eating candy corn, by the way. Hi guys. Yeah, okay. Anyway, besides that, also Jared improved his writing skill to level 5, which means he can write humor novels now. And what else? The repairman came, it was actually a woman, so the repairwoman came because Jared broke the computer, you know, why not? Or the laptop, shall I say. And he also decides to play soccer when I told him to dance, which is funny because he loves dancing, but, you know, he decided to play soccer, so he gained him an athletic skill. And Ruben got a jackpot, Maria came home with some money. Wow, she increased her gambling skill to level 5, and she just got a jackpot. It's pretty cool. And okay, sure. Yeah, actually that thing was to give it or to tell Emily Ilop, which is his daughter. So yeah, and then Derek came home with some money, and her, since she was losing, I made her switch to this machine right here, and my game froze. Wow, that doesn't ever happen. Okay, much better. So she has to use the bathroom too, so whenever she has to go, she can go. So yeah, and she earned us 6,000 simoleons about around there, and she learned how to make Maria learned how to make LMS masala curry, and then she read 5 unique books, and he also got $5,000. Where is he going? Order hot dogs. You can really order hot dogs? Really? Oh, okay, that's cool. Not really creative foods, but yeah, he can order himself some hot dogs. That's fine. Perfectly fine with me, Ruben. So he earned about like 5,000 and a half. She just got a checkbot, and Maria learned how to make chili con carne. And then that's kind of it. That is just what happened right now. But I will continue. Hopefully, I'm going to try. Derek's sleeping right now because he's like fatigued and stuff. I just made him go to bed so he has enough energy to stay up. And during the night time, but I just made him go to sleep because he has nothing better to do, of course. But, yeah, so I'm gonna try and get him abducted, which he's getting up right now, which is awesome. And, I'm gonna see if he gets abducted. If not, then I'll come back whenever something interesting happens, and I'll tell you what happens again. So, yeah. Alright, I will be right back. Just because I want to update you on her belly, there it is, and yeah, that's kind of it. Day 2 for being pregnant. That's it. You're not gonna listen to no tapcast, okay? You're gonna make the bed for all of us, okay? Oh, you made the bed the other side. Okay, make this side of the bed. Anyway, he did not get abducted, as you can tell. Some things did happen though. From yesterday, Carmen had an accident. Oops. She wanted to eat fish and chips, but she couldn't make it to the bathroom in the casino faster because it's like all the way on the other side. It's crazy, but you know, whatever. And also, Jared and Maria got this eternally faithful mullet because they were eternally faithful, you know? Duh. No, I'm kidding. But, you know, and Maria learned how to make cookies, and then he got his, book royalties today, The Secret Life of an Everyday Dancer, 46 simoleons, and How to Dance, 49 simoleons. So altogether, 95 simoleons. And also, right now, I forgot to tell you yesterday, but he is writing a book, obviously, in his underwear. I mean, how else would you write a book? But it's called The Dancing Queen. It's a drama novel. The first one was, I'm guessing it was like a fiction. I don't really remember when I made it. And the second one was a nonfiction, and this one is a drama. So obviously all his books are going to be about dancing because he just loves to dance. I have to make the next one about dancing in underwear or something like that. Well, let's see. I don't know what genre though. We'll see. Maybe I don't think he can make children's books. I don't know. Whatever. We'll see something. So yeah, I'll come back if anything else happens. Oh, and Ruben is 101 days old today. Oh my god. And they are actually about 10,000 simoleons away from being worth 100,000 simoleons. So once they reach 100,000, well, a little bit over that, they can move into that new house. So by the time this episode is finished, they will be moved into that house, and hopefully I can give you a quick tour around it and stuff. And then, yeah. Oh, what you guys doing over here? What's she telling you? Talking about computers? Okay, whatever. You need to eat, though, because you're going back there, okay? And she made some eggs. Okay, how do you pronounce this thing? Machiavellian. It's raining the second day in a row. Oh, by the way, it's summer. And the first day of summer is when there's like these firework bundles at the, what is it called? At the grocery store. Yeah, so you could buy firework bundles, just basically, you know, a bunch of fireworks. A little bit cheaper than usual, I'm guessing. Yeah, sure. So, yeah, I will come back whenever something happens. Let's see, okay? Hey, guys. Okay, so a couple of things. First, it is Levi's birthday. Who knew? I don't know what that meant. I don't know what that sound was, but apparently it's his birthday. Yeah. So, little Levi has grown up, and he has that weird custom content. due to your excellent parenting skills, you may now choose a trait for Levi to develop. So that's pretty cool. I'm gonna randomize it. Okay, good. He is good. That's very nice. And another thing, you might hear an alien in the background. You might not. I had to fix his outfit. But yeah, there's an alien. Woo! Where did they go? Right there. Yay, there's an alien! We invited Zarar over. Yeah, Zeror over. And yeah, so that's that. That is that. I'm gonna change Levi's outfit and all that stuff. So yeah. And also, whoa, she wants to woohoo with an alien? No. Your sim has always suspected they were special. These visitors, they must be here for your sim to make them a special connection with the one who truly understands them. Hopefully aliens aren't into weird stuff. No. Okay, but no. All right, so that was that, apparently, and a lot of other things that happened. Oh, that's what that sound was. Well, okay, first Carmen went to go buy some apples from the grocery store, so she went on a shopping spree, and then he got some more money, and then we got that much money, $6,000 from the slot machine. Then Carmen got to level 6 in gambling, Levi's birthday, and then awesome, there was some extra food today, so your boss gave you an extra portion of cheese plate. Okay, it could have gave us some like baked angel food cake, but cheese plate, you know, whatever, I'm not complaining, at least it's something. We'll put that in the refrigerator right now. Excellent quality, that's how it looks like. Just a plate of cheese and some other stuff. And then she came back from work. And today was Maria's 1 year anniversary working at Little Corsican bistro, her coworkers threw her a party. So that's what that little jingle was that you heard. I was like, what is that? And Maria celebrates a year of productive work. And, maybe this was it. Congratulations, as a reward for your advancement to pastry chef, you've been allowed to keep the following acquisition ingredient eviscerator 236 times. Look for it in your family inventory when you come home. Really? We have to check that out. And then she got promoted to pastry chef. She now makes 108 simoleons per hour. Really nice. And pretty much she watched Levi grow up, and that's kind of cool. Nobody else was watching, really. Neither was Maria, but I mean, whatever. Oh, this one. It's a blender. Okay, we'll keep the blender. There is a blender in the other house. We might as well delete some of these stuff. Cowboy Angel. Okay, well. Oh, and a picture of puppies. We'll keep that. And this thing with the little panda bears on it. And this picture, custom cotton content. And here's a pot of plants. It's the pot of plants and flowers and all that stuff. So basically that's what happened there. And I'll come back if anything else happens. Hopefully, do we have enough money? Oh, almost. We need $2,000 more till we get $100,000, and then a little bit more over. I'm not really sure. I think it was 106 or a little bit more. I'm not sure. A little bit less, maybe. So yeah, I'll come back. Hopefully when we get the new house or something else happens. So I'll come back very soon. And also, the reason that we invited Derek invited the alien over was because I think I read this somewhere. I'm not 100% sure, so don't quote me. What is Jared doing out here? Beat up! You better not beat up that alien. Jared, no. No, no. No, no, no. because I thought I read somewhere that maybe if you befriend an alien, possibly you get to a higher chance of them coming to abduct you. I'm not really sure. I don't think that's true. Maybe I just made that all up, but that toilet is still dirty. We cleaned that in the morning. Maria, cooking it. But I wasn't kidding. She's gonna go clean it anyway after she eats. So yeah, hopefully we'll befriend him, and then hopefully they'll want to come and abduct Derek soon, you know? Whatever. So yeah, I'll come back whenever something happens. See you guys then. Okay, so before we do anything else, I just changed the outfit of Levi. This is his sleepwear. I'm not gonna really go through every single outfit because you'll eventually see all of them. But this is him. That's his face. He has really big lips, I guess. I don't know how, why, maybe. I don't really know who. From who did he get those big lips? Maria doesn't have all the biggest lips. Jared doesn't either. Last time I checked. Does he? Maybe from Jared? It doesn't look like he have big like he has big lips. Oh, he's old. Stop moving. Possibly. There's a cat. No. They look small. Like, what is he doing with this face? Oh my god. Everybody wants to pet this cat. Bella cat. Fine. Pet it. He did a treat. Give it a smoochie and then hug it because it needs love. I don't know whose cat this is. Is it the aliens? Because it's not a stray cat. Because then it would be called a stray cat, but yeah, whatever. And then, we got some gifts and stuff. Who is this? That's Thelma? Okay. And then we got Jared's complimentary books and stuff. Came in the mail and stuff like that. So, yeah, I will pick up whenever something happens. Okay. Nothing's working. Demi just came out as a ghost, and she started haunting the space rock, so she's in it now. But what I want to do is actually, I don't know if this works, but I'm gonna try after, you know, Derek uses the bathroom. I'm gonna try to analyze the space rocks in his inventory at least, and maybe we'll do it after. But I swear nothing's working. Oh, that's Jared. Oh, what's he doing? Please don't beat up. Why does he love to beat up other Sims now? I don't get that. I really don't. You know what? You're not doing anything, so go ahead and write. But anyway, what happened is we got a lot of money, obviously. You know, we got that $100,000. So I will be moving them in whenever everybody gets, like, settled, like, gets ready, takes the showers, or not even takes a shower, just wakes up and just gets home, because they should be coming home. Reuben too. I'm gonna have him stop doing that. He earned only 1,000 from that, and then she already has. Well, she got like 10,000. Well, let's see. First she got a jackpot. Then her gambling skill went up to level 7. I think the same as Reuben's. She actually has like a hot slot machine right now, which is awesome. And then she got another jackpot, and then she got like us. She got us almost 11 grand, and then Reuben's, yeah, he just improved his skill to level 8. So they're like a skill. skill level apart. And then my Overwatch mod deleted some vehicles that were unnecessary, so I'm going to have them kind of get situated, and I swear hopefully in that lot we'll get abducted. There's plenty of space for it to happen. I don't see why it's not, but here too there's like plenty of space here. Maybe it's, I don't know, I moved the tree away so it can happen, but I don't know if it's the space, if it's just my game hates me or something, but this is the only game I ever tried to get abducted. I swear, it's probably this game. It's like there's only one alien in the whole town, and I guess he was at our house, and he's a male. I would like a female sim, so, you know, he can get Derek pregnant, or she can get Derek pregnant, but yeah, I'm gonna put in the house, and this alien's smelly now. Look at him! He's so buff! Oh my god! But yeah, I'm gonna go, like, put in the town. I'm not gonna go yet. I'm just gonna put it in, hopefully maybe give you a tour around it, a quick tour. Yeah, this video will be a little bit longer, so yeah, so I'll do that and I'll come right back, okay? The alien's going home. Just thought I should show you that. Get in a little spaceship. Come back tomorrow night and abduct Derek, please. Please. Well, yeah, he found a bunch of stuff. Oh, I gotta go. Bye. Be back. We'll be waiting for you. So, yeah, he found a lot of stuff. He analyzed all of them, hopefully. I think so. Yeah, he did. So, yeah, that's pretty much that. And I'll have them go to their house and stuff. Before we move, what do you call it? Derek, that's what you call him, got a brain freeze from eating a snow cone. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have eaten that so quickly. Sorry for the long pause, I was reading this, but yeah, we're gonna move now. Reuben, you're not going to work. Don't even think about it. You're not going to work. And then he got this moodlit raspberry romance. When the sun is high in the sky, the flowers are blooming, and there's a raspberry snow cone in Reuben's hand. He can't help but think of love. And then he is eating, a blue raspberry too. So yeah, that's that. And we'll move. I promise we'll move. Okay, we're going now. Okay, it's time to move. So let's just stand in the wall where I can't see your face, Reuben. I can kind of see it from the mirror a bit. So we're gonna take everyone. The little one just went to school. We're gonna sell the furniture. We got some. I put some of the furniture, like the pictures and the tombstone, of course. I put that in the family inventory so we won't forget it. Or actually, Reuben has that kind of stuff. A couple of the stuff in his personal inventory, I guess you can call it. So we're gonna take everyone, like I said, to a house which is right there, because I mean, it's the closest house that was like to us, because then we're at a house like right next to us. And also that house was the only time we actually saw an alien there, I think. Yeah, I think that was the only time we actually saw the alien. So I'm gonna put it in there. Of course I didn't build it in there, so it's kind of like I built it in another town and I kind of put this house in there, so it might like mess up, but I feel like still the lot could be special, could be where aliens want to go, so that's why I built it there. And now we have 8,000 simoleons left, which is perfect. Yeah, the house is worth 102,905 simoleons, so we're gonna go. Yeah, we're gonna do it. So that's kind of it. Bye bye, house. Bye bye. Bye bye. That's our family. Yes. And that's pretty much it. So gonna look at the house one last time before we all go. Everybody's kind of doing their thing. Everybody has to wake up and go. They should be going soon. Yeah. But yeah, this is the house. It's kind of like the last of it. There it is. We kind of took the soccer thing with us too. We kind of took the dartboard, but whatever. Meh, whatever. That's fine. We'll leave it there. Oh, we didn't take the exercise machine. Oh, that's okay. That's fine. We could buy another one if we really wanted one. Okay, that's it. That's the house. Everyone go. Go, 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 go. And everybody's moving now. And the summer festival came to town as well, because it's the second day of summer, the day after the first day of summer, if you like to say it that way. So yeah, it's kind of it. It's nice. I might give you a tour around the house. I don't know how much time I'll have. I mean, you probably really want to know or see a tour of the house, but the little one's in school working his butt off because he went late. Oh my god, horse! A horse! He wants to sign up for an after-school activity. Possibly. They're not even going to take anything there. Just going to walk around the block. And this is the house. I did build it myself. I'm happy with it. I like it. Of course, I'm still a beginner in building homes, but this is kind of it. And I'll have them kind of get settled in and go inside. It's this very warm kind of themed home. The roof is a bit, I'll show you an overview. The roof is a bit crazy because roofs are a bit challenging to do, especially with homes looking like this. But yeah, so that's the house, and I'll give you a quick tour around it. Hopefully once everybody gets inside. Oh, the boy just came to our house. Now he's coming to the new house. So yeah. Give you actually a 360 around it first. Little trees and stuff. I'm proud. I'm happy about like how this house turned out. It is a one story again, but I mean, it's expensive for a reason. So I'll definitely show you that. Look at her slow pregnant butt going there. So slow. Okay, come on. We're waiting for you. Okay, so everybody's kind of inside. Let's go downstairs. Walls up. So they're all on the way, they're all confused, and they're all tired. Most importantly, they're all tired. Yeah, room and cold and fake sick, by the way. So here's the first part, the living room, I guess you could say. It's a really awkward shape. It is, and I worked around that. I tried to. This part is very modern, very different from the rest of the house. Oh my god, I'm making so much noise outside. Unbelievable. So here's their little area. We will decorate it with a little bit, like flowers and stuff there. And then here's a bunch of scattered plants in the corner because there was nothing there and I decided to put that there. Look at her face. She's thinking about herself. Oh god. This is the study area where we might put up a laptop here, or might just not, might just leave it like that, but I'm pretty sure we're gonna have to put that laptop there for Jared, of course. Don't mind the plants coming through the walls. You'll see that a lot in this house, I know. And then over here is this phonogram, I think it's called. I don't even know what it is. That's what it said when you look at the catalog. I think it's a phonogram. And the little sun clock thing, mirror. It's a mirror. And then this thing is custom content. I just decided to put it here because it's like a painting and I needed something to go on this wall. It just felt so boring. I guess I could have put a phone. That's what you call it. Oh my god, it's a phone. I'm living in the 21st century. I don't even know what a phone, I forgot what a phone is called. Whatever, here it is. I kind of like it. I think it's like tree and seasons. Yeah, I put it there just because. And then over here is the kitchen. Again, you can see like the little, well, for the first time in this inside house, you can see this rock pattern, and I brought it down to the half wall as well. I thought that was kind of neat. And I guess we could go over here first. You can see the master bedroom has like double doors and wall in the way. Nice little lights. Pretty interesting. And this random little awkward little hallway, but I think it's cute. There used to be like a recycling bin in here. I put it outside because I wanted a door. There was a door through the master bedroom to go to the outside deck patio area, but I put a door in there instead because it just felt right. I don't want my guests, when they want to go outside, I don't want them to go either outside out the front door or through the master bedroom and then outside. So I don't think that would be right. And I use the same set from Sim Street Store in this house as like in our old house. It's a Edwardian kitchen set, something like that. I think that's what it is. And I put a nice little pop of color with the plants there and these pots with flowers on them. And there we go. There we got that blender again. It's different though. It's a different blender, but still, same colors. I mean, different colors, same blender. Woo! Can't think straight. And then here's a seasons table with some seasons dining chairs. This wall is blank because this is where I would put all their thingy-ma-bobs on. These things. Let me put them on really quickly. Right there. And then the winter one. All right there. Okay, fine. Fine. Go low like that. Like, why? Okay, good. Good. And then over here. Maybe we can put it up higher, possibly. Okay, I'll change that. That looks really weird now. But I'll move them down or up or something a bit later. But that's how it is going to be. And I guess we can go into the smaller bedrooms now. I guess we could start from the middle. Yeah, here is, okay. Here is, like, Ruben's and Levi's bedroom, because Ruben won't be living for long. And I didn't have space in this house for his bedroom, so he's gonna have to share it with Levi for now. And, basically, yeah, your curtains, you got your bunk beds, your little alarm clock there, I think it's super cute. A little place to play video games and some posters, because that's always fun. And the bookshelf isn't straight, I know, I thought it would be kind of interesting if you could put it sideways-ish, like that. And you got another poster, and, beanbag chairs with the TV facing them. I could possibly put a video console there, a video game console there, if you guys wanted me to. And then there's this cute little thing that came with university. It's like a nightlight. I think it's just so interesting. Oh my god, curtain, get out of my way, okay? So it's so cute. It's like a nightlight with the little university, like, mascot symbol thing for their school. So I think that's really adorable. Really nice. So I put it in Levi's bedroom because it was green and the room theme is mostly green, as you can tell. And to the left, the most left door-ish, I guess that makes sense, is Maria and Jared's room. Their old room was like greenish also, but it was like a warm color. It was like a warm color. So this time I made it like a cool blue color, a very cold, like, cool, you know, because blue is like cold, yeah, I guess. So I gave them the same bed, just different patterns and colors and stuff, and lights and alarm clock that was blue, so I put it in there, and the same season's curtains but just different design. And over here, a chair from Diesel and some plants and a mirror and a dresser that also came with seasons. And then they got this little kitty calendar because this wall was so plain and I had to put something on it. So I put this kitty calendar. It's just green. It's just a pop of color. It matches with the plants. So, I mean, why not? And then I guess we can go quickly to this bathroom. It's a guest bathroom slash those bathroom belonging to those two rooms. Yeah, this is the second bathroom in the house. Or one of out of two bathrooms in the house. You got your toilet, you got your little sink with a red towel that matches this home sweet home kind of thing on the wall, decor item on the wall. You know, your basic necessities for a bathroom. It's just a bathroom, that's all it is. And before we head to the master bedroom, we kind of saw it there, but I like these things over here, these like way I did that, because it kind of divides the room without putting an arch, so that therefore whenever I play the music, I won't have to put those speakers that like transfer the music to every room. I just have one, and you can hear it when you're in the kitchen, when you're in the dining room, when you're in the main living room and the little study area, I guess you could call it, I guess. And oh my god, what are they doing out there? And so yeah, I like these little dividers. You can see here are two, and you can divide them from the master bedroom. They're also kind of cool, and I guess it kind of divides here too, from the living room and the dining room. I mean, from the kitchen and the dining room, but I mean, I like that. I like that a lot. So I think it's something new and cool. I did that in the last house from the living room. Her face though. So now to the master bedroom. Here it is. It's also that very, like, beige color the bed is mostly, and it's that warm kind of tinted color. Here's a 360 of it, I guess you could say. What I liked about this room, I put the bed on the platform, and again, it's like plain bed sheets, but I think the painting, it's like their hair color. It's like Carmen's and Derek's hair color, so you could imagine that's them in the picture, like, kissing, and then, in the background, there's the Paris, like, the Eiffel Tower, and all that good stuff. I don't know why I said Paris. It's obviously an Eiffel Tower, not Paris. Well, you know, whatever. Anyway, and you got this, over here. When I originally made the house, I just made little awkward shapes to get the design. And over here, I made this little thing, and obviously I put rock outside of it to make it, like, different from the, whatever that sliding wallpaper. So I just made it stone to match these, and I was like, wow, this is perfect kind of room for a fireplace. So I put one in, and this one kind of matched with the theme of the house, so I just put it in and then made the room kind of match towards it, I guess. And I put some plants and a vanity in case, you know, why not? It's a vanity, you need one, and you could lay in the bed and look at yourself in the mirror, I mean, if you really wanted to. And then you have a couple of chairs to sit by the fireplace if you wanted to as well. And then you have your flat screen TV, your plant, that's another pop of color, and another plant there. Another thing that I liked about this house, or this room especially, I made these like mirrors to make it seem like it's a larger room. I could have done that in the Maria's and Jared's room as well, but I originally did it in this room, and I think it looked nice. I mean, not that this room could needs to be bigger or look bigger, but I mean, I did it in here and I thought it matched because this wall was really plain, and I think the calendar was enough for the other room. I don't want to over like dramatically put stuff on the walls. And here's the bathroom. It's really small, but the season's shower slash bathtub is awesome. I love this object. I always use it constantly, all the time. I just love it. I wish they would make more in like different varieties. Hopefully, I think we'll see that in the next, not the next expansion pack, in the more future upcoming expansion packs or something. Hopefully, because I like this thing. And yeah, there's only one design to it right now. So, but I love it anyway. And then you got the toilet. You gotta reach for the toilet paper across the room, but that's okay. It's not that far away. And then you got your little pop of green there. It's not much. It matches with the plants coming through the foundation and the wall, but hey, let's, you know, get away from that tannish color. Got some green for the towel there. And that's kind of it. Let's go to the outside. I was gonna originally put the grill out here, but there was no room. Like, there was like, oh, the staircases are in the way. So, there's no grill now. But there is a place to sit and a table. And then you got your pool, because you need a pool. You need a pool for the pool parties, which we will be throwing one because it's summer again. Got a little trampoline there. Well, it's not so little, but you get the point. And then, of course, I had to include the nice little basketball court area with three little balls, a soccer ball, a football, and then a baseball. And you can obviously see if you throw the ball over the fence, you can go into your old house's backyard and all that stuff. I just realized we never put a fence around it. Well, we never had enough money, but now we do. But we don't live there anymore. So this house is a fence though. So I think that's kind of nice. And then over here again, I put two spaces for the cars to park in. And we only have one car, but hopefully in the future we will buy another one. And I don't know, I really like this house. I don't know how long this video has been. I'm gonna add all the stuff in and come back to you in the next episode. So hope you guys did enjoy though. And then we'll just pick up from then. I'm really proud of this house. Tell me your guys' thoughts on what you think about this house. I think it's nice. Weird reflection coming from that mirror though, like when I zoom out it's like black, but yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, favorite, and subscribe. If you guys do want to download this house, it will be coming out on the exchange very soon for free, of course, with the first ever house over there, I think, when we first started. And right now I'll put that both of those homes on the exchange. So, in case I confused you, that house, the old house, is going to come out from the very first episode, how it looked from the very first episode, and how it looked in part 30. And this house is going to come out when it looked how it looked in part 30. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Again, I'm going to say this again. I feel like I'm a broken record. Don't forget to like, comment, favorite, and subscribe. Believe in yourself. I love you guys. And game on. Bye. Okay, seriously, bye now. Bye.